Hello guys, welcome back to another series of Motivation for Programmers. So in this video series, this episode is about imposter syndrome. And you know, most people, most programmers around the world who code must go through this stage. I have gone through it. I still have some setbacks. So this video is like another way to encourage myself and encourage others that imposter syndrome is real and you can combat it. So I'm going to give you a brief description about what is imposter syndrome and how you can fight back on imposter syndrome. So this is still the number one episode. So before that, please, I want you to smash that like button. Please hit the subscribe button. And don't forget to turn on the notification so that whenever a new video drops, you get it. So right, let's get straight into it. So first of all, what is imposter syndrome? So if I head over to my to Google and search on imposter syndrome, yeah, so like I just did, now you'll see it says imposter syndrome is loosely defined as doubting your abilities and feeling like a fraud. That sums it all. That sums the definition of somebody who has imposter syndrome. You feel like you're a fraud, you feel like you're not competent enough. And there are some roadmaps or there are some things that lead you up to that point where you think you are not worthy of calling yourself a programmer. Something like this happens. For example, you open YouTube, like I do. Let's just open YouTube. And on YouTube, we check on the guys who post YouTube videos online. You see a guy has made a live stream and he has done a ReactJS course on how to build a Netflix clone. I mean, he's doing like a live stream. You see, like, everything is real. And you're like, man, I've been learning this thing like for 2 years and I'm not able to even build a simple static website. And this guy is cloning Netflix. What the hell? So that reaction is what finally leads to that imposter syndrome. Anytime you feel like getting on the computer, you want to type something, you want to code, you get that feeling or that thinking, that negativity in your brain that telling you that you're not competent enough. Because reason number one, you saw that guy on YouTube, he did a live stream on cloning Netflix and you can do that. So an imposter syndrome signs start coming from things like when you start comparing yourself to others. So when you start comparing yourself, thinking that, oh, this guy is better than I do, this guy is building many projects, that is imposter syndrome. It consumes you gradually until it reaches the point where you decide to quit. But that is the purpose of this video. I don't want you to quit. So for you not to quit, you have to follow these simple steps in order to quit imposter syndrome. Number one, don't compare yourself to others. Don't. If you try that, you're gonna die, man. Like, literally, you die. So, don't take that serious, you can't die. So, what do I mean by don't compare yourself? It simply means that it's not like you should not learn from people online who share tutorials. It's just don't compare your style of learning or your speed of learning to that of another person who maybe has had experience, or the person is slightly having an advantage over you, maybe due to the resources he has, or the person is a little bit intelligent in grasping concepts like that. You have to accept who you are. You have to know your limitations. You have to know your strengths and you work on those. That is how you are not able to compare yourself to others. It's when you understand your strengths. I know of people who are very good in web design, but they are so bad at back-end development. You have people who prefer the back-end development and they are so poor in the design, like I am. So you have to know your strengths. Your strength should be the motivating force. You say, okay, this guy is doing a live stream of Netflix to us. That's him. He has been there for a while. Let me tell you, most of those guys, they have prepared something in the background before coming there. They don't just get on the screen and they're typing. No, it's not magic. They have to plan for the live stream. So you have to take into consideration that you too can get there if you work hard. You have to pay, you know, you have to be consistent. That's one key. The second way to for you to combat imposter syndrome is something that people ignore it, but it's very important, is to motivate yourself by doing little projects or little bonuses that can get you to a level where your confidence levels are high. What do I mean by that? So let me use an example to help you understand. Take for instance, if you want a kid, a toddler who is still trying to learning how to walk, if you bring in something like sweets, you drop it like in front of the toddler a little bit ahead, well, what the toddler is going to do is they need the sweet, so they are going to do what? They're going to move forward and pick the first sweet. You keep dropping the sweet, the sweet along the way, or those nutritious stuffs along the way, they will keep following it till they get the grander prize. So it's the same thing with programming. You want to succeed, you have to take those small steps which will lead to the big steps. So you have to self-motivate yourself. Don't go ahead to start learning how to clone a website, clone Netflix, how to build this, how to build that, how to build Google. No, we can't be Google though. So don't go to those big stuff. Start somewhere, something little. You can say, okay, how can I create a nav bar? Or maybe if you're somebody who is more into machine learning, you know, how to create my first linear regression algorithm that does a simple analysis of data. You start from somewhere, you start little, and when you build your first one, that should be the motivating force that guides you to the next project. You increase step by step, you don't move from beginner and you go to an advanced topic. You're going to lose motivation. So start from little and then you move your way up, and that is going to increase your confidence level. So the more you complete the little projects, the better you get at completing little projects, that is how advanced you become subsequently. Now, number three is consistency. Now, imposter syndrome is that idea of you having fraud because you think you're not good enough. And when you think you're not good enough, you start to slack off from time to time on your screen. You no longer code, maybe in a very long while. And this will lead you to being an inconsistent programmer. So how can you solve it? You solve it by being consistent. When I go on YouTube, I hear guys saying like you need to code like 10 to 16 hours a day. That's bungles. That's nonsense. You don't need to code for 10 hours a day. Based on your schedule or based on how your life, your program is, that is how you should code. If your time schedule shows you can code for 1 hour, you make sure that when you sit on your screen, 1 hour it is, and you use it, and you code for 1 hour. But if you have someone like me, I have an advantage. I can sit maybe two or three more hours or four. Yeah, you make use of the time. So the point is consistency. If you continuously make yourself available to code every day, so along the way, you're going to find yourself doing more better and better. And with that consistency, you're gonna build up a whole portfolio of different projects you have made. Now let's go to the fourth reason. How to combat imposter syndrome. And I think it's one of my most important on the list. Reduce social media. Now, what do I mean? I see beginner programmers, when they start learning programming, like I did, I subscribed to like 100 programming channels. I mean, like, it was not easy. I was like watching videos like literally every day. I could watch like 10 to 15 videos on a topic, and it just overwhelmed me, and it made me feel I'm not useful enough. Calm down. Select a few channels, like 3, 4, 5, 6, for me maximum 10, which contain the list of things you want to learn, or you find the best teacher that can teach you and you stick to it. Don't be moving bongos, because these guys on YouTube, they are doing a great job producing these tutorials. these YouTubers, there are many of them who work their asses off to get those tutorials. So those people who work a lot to get those tutorials and prepare those videos, they won't stop making those videos because you have imposter syndrome. Yeah, that's the literal truth. They won't stop, but they will keep on producing those videos. It's up to you to learn how to control yourself. You need to stop using media to talk about those things, about to receive notifications. Imagine in one day you're receiving about 50 notifications from programming channels, how to build this, how to build that. Man, you're gonna multiply, even quadruple your imposter syndrome effectiveness on you. Like, it will go crazy. So slow down a bit, don't watch too many tutorials, keep a balance, and try to work more on project-based apps. So next up, I want you to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Don't forget to smash the subscribe button, hit that notification bell, turn on it, and comment if you have any questions to me, and I'll do my best to answer. See you in the next video. Ciao.